In the last lecture, we discussed about inverting and non-inverting amplifier, and we say that the inverting amplifier is the most basic circuit we will be using for other application. So today we are going to look at the adder and subtractor circuit. Let's first look at the adder circuit. So what is adder basically? So if I have signal V1 and another signal V2, the output should be proportional to or ideally equal to V1 plus V2. That's what adder is. Now instead of two signal, if I have four signal, V1, V2, V3 and V4, then V out ideally has to be equal to at least proportional to V1 plus V2 plus V3 plus V4. We are going to achieve this particular thing using operational amplifier. And for that, again, we are going to use the simple inverting amplifier. We are going to use the circuit for inverting amplifier and we are going to modify it. So this is the circuit for inverting amplifier. And we apply input V in and we get output V out, which is equal to minus of RF by R1 times V in. So basically minus RF by R1 is gain of this amplifier. So V out will be minus of RF by R1 into V in. And while calculating this particular thing, what we have considered? We have considered that if some current is flowing from this input resistance is I1 and the current flowing through this feedback resistance is IF, and since there is no current flowing inside this operational amplifier, I1 has to be equal to IF, and based on that we solve this and we obtain this particular thing. Now what's going to happen if instead of one R1 I'm going to use different resistances, and instead of one input I'm going to use different inputs? So what if the circuit, I modify the circuit to look something like this? So what I have done over here is that instead of using a single resistance and a single input Vin, I have used four different inputs V1, V2, V3, V4, and I have fed these particular inputs to the non-inverting terminal, to the inverting terminal using resistance R1, R2, R3, R4 and so on. Right? So basically this is the non-inverting amplifier circuit, just I have modified it. Now what is going to happen? Since this is R1 and the applied voltage is V1, the current flowing over here will be equal to I1. The current flowing through this circuit will be I2. The current flowing through this circuit will be I3. And the current flowing through this circuit is I4. And all these currents are coming together at this particular junction. And a single current I is flowing from here. So can somebody tell me what will be the value of I from Kirchhoff's current law? We know that since all currents are coming at one particular point, then therefore the current after that particular point will be equal to sum of all the current. So this is I1 plus I2 plus I3 plus I4. And since no current flows inside this operational amplifier, all the current should flow through this feedback resistance. And if the current is IF, I have I is equal to IF. Now what is the value of I1? The value of I1 will be potential drop across this resistance divided by the value of resistance. Now since the inverting terminal is grounded, the potential at this particular point will be 0 volt, and that voltage is applied at this particular terminal and at this particular terminal and at this terminal and at this particular terminal. So across each resistance, one terminal is having a voltage which is equal to the applied voltage and the another terminal will have a voltage is equal to 0. Therefore for I1 the value will be equal to V1 minus 0 divided by R1. So that would be V1 by R1. Similarly I2 will be equal to V2 divided by R2. I3 will be equal to V3 divided by R3. And I4 will be equal to V4 divided by R4. And what is the value of IF? IF will be equal to 0 minus V out divided by RF. So that would be minus V out divided by RF. If I have this particular equation, I'm going to have minus V out divided by RF, which is equal to IF, is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. So that would be V1 divided by R1 plus V2 divided by R2 plus V3 divided by R3 plus V4 divided by R4. What if I have R1 is equal to R2 is equal to R3 is equal to R4 is equal to RF is equal to, let's say, R. If all the resistances are equal, then all these resistances will get cancelled, and I am going to have minus Vout is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3 plus V4. And hence, the output voltage of this particular circuit is equal to minus of V1 plus V2 plus V3 plus V4. So what I have done, by choosing all the resistances, input resistances and the feedback resistance of the same value, I have achieved a addition of all the input voltage, albeit with a negative sign. But I have achieved the addition of this particular voltages. This is what your adder circuit is. So in an adder circuit, you fed up the signal using input resistances having the same value. If I have V1, I am going to feed it through R. If I am V2, I am going to feed it through same resistance R. If I have V3, I am going to feed it using the same resistance R. V4 using the same resistance R. And all these voltages are connected to inverting terminal of an operational amplifier, and the non-inverting terminal of operational amplifier is grounded. And then I'm going to use the feedback using a feedback resistance RF, which has a value equal to the same R, and it is connected to Vout. And if I have such a circuit, the output will be minus of V1 plus V2 plus V3 plus V4. This is what your adder circuit is. So as you have seen, we have only make use of inverting amplifier circuit. That's the basic circuit that we are going to use for many applications. Using that basic circuit, we have achieved a adder. Now let's look at the subtractor circuit. So what is subtractor? So basically, if I have two signals V1 and V2, then at output, I should have Vout equal to V2 minus V1. Now how I can achieve this particular thing? Obviously, we are just going to modify the inverting amplifier. So the inverting amplifier circuit is this. Now if I am using this inverting amplifier, and if I have applied, let's say, V1 over here, the output will be equal to minus of RF divided by R1 V1. Instead of this, if I use non-inverting amplifier, something like this, inverting terminal is grounded, and I have applied, let's say, V2 over here, then my Vout will be equal to 1 plus RF upon R1 V2. Now if I make, let's say, for both the circuits, if I take R1 is equal to RF, that time from this particular inverting amplifier, I am going to get output voltage is equal to minus V1. But from this inverting amplifier, non-inverting amplifier, the output voltage will be 2 times V2. And if I combine these two circuits, then my Vout will be simply 2V2 minus V1, right? So by combining these two circuits, I can perform a subtraction operation, but it's not giving me this particular value. Instead of V2, I'm going to get 2V2. So I need to take care of this particular thing. So that is the basic thing that we are going to do. So what we are going to do for subtractor, we are going to combine inverting and non-inverting amplifier. And in order to take care of this output is equal to 2V2, what I'm going to do, instead of applying V2 over here, I'm going to apply a voltage of V2 by 2. Now, if the applied voltage is V2 by 2, then the output Vout will be equal to V2 only. Instead of 2V2, if RF is equal to R1, instead of 2V2, I'm going to get V2. So how to achieve this particular thing? That's the first thing that we are going to do. Suppose I have two resistances connected something like this. And let's suppose this is R1, this is R2, and the applied voltage is V. What is the amount of current that is flowing through this particular circuit? The current that is flowing through the circuit I is equal to V divided by R1 plus R2. And therefore, if I want to find out what is the voltage appearing across this R2, which will be, if I connect this particular point to something else, that will be the voltage applied. The voltage at this particular point over here will be the voltage across this R2, and that will be VR2, which is equal to R2 into I, which is equal to R2 divided by R1 plus R2 into V. Now, if I have R1 is equal to R2, if the values of these resistances are same, then VR2 will be equal to V by 2. This particular arrangement is known as voltage divider arrangement. So by using this simple voltage divided by divider arrangement, I can apply half the voltage. So over here I said that if instead of V2, if I apply V2/2, then my problem will be solved. So I'm going to use this such a voltage divider arrangement for non-inverting terminal. So the circuit, the final circuit for subtractor will look something like this. So what I have done, I have used this particular voltage divider arrangement over here to apply this particular voltage. And let's analyze this particular circuit. Let's look at V2 first. So if I look at this particular circuit, I'm going to have something like this. I have a voltage V2 and there is R2 and this particular terminal is connected and there is R3. So at this non-inverting terminal, this is my non-inverting terminal over here. At non-inverting terminal, the voltage applied will be the voltage appearing across this R3, and therefore the voltage appearing across non-inverting terminal is equal to current flowing through this particular circuit I into R3, and as you have found previously, this I is nothing but this I will be equal to applied voltage divided by the total resistance. Therefore V plus will be equal to R3 divided by R2 plus R3. This is my V plus. So at this particular junction, the applied voltage is V plus, and if I use the concept of virtual ground, since there is no current flowing through this inverting and non-inverting terminal, so since the input resistance is input impedance of this operational amplifier is infinite, the voltage appearing at non-inverting terminal will be the voltage appearing across at the inverting terminal. So over here also I am going to have voltage V plus. So at this point I have voltage V plus. Now look at this particular circuit. Let's analyze this circuit. Now if this current is flowing is I1, this current will be equal to IF. Then we know that since no current flows through the operational amplifier, I1 is equal to IF, and the value of I1 will be the potential difference across R1, which is equal to V1 minus the voltage at this particular point, V plus, divided by R1. And what is IF? IF will be V plus minus Vout divided by RF. I have these three equations. This is equation A, this is equation B, C, and this is equation D. Now, if I put the value of C and D in equation B, then I'm going to have V1 minus V plus divided by R1 is equal to V plus by RF minus V out by RF. So basically V1 by R1 minus V plus by R1 is equal to V plus by RF minus V out by RF. That will give me V1 by R1 is equal to V plus by R1 plus V plus by RF minus V out. And from equation A, the value of V plus is equal to, there has to be the applied voltage, so there has to be V2 over here. So V plus is R3 divided by R2 plus R3 divided by V into V2. If I put the values in this particular equation, I'm going to get V1 by R is equal to 1 over R1 R3 into R2 plus R3 divided by into V2 plus R3 divided by R2 plus R3 V2 by RF plus, with a minus sign, minus V out by RF. Now if all these resistances are equal, so basically if R1 is equal to R2 is equal to R3 is equal to RF is equal to R, then I'm going to have something like this. V1 by R is equal to R3 is equal to R, so R divided by 2R, so that would be 1 over R, sorry, 1 by 2, so this would be 1 divided by 2R, V2 plus again R divided by 2R, that would be half, so this will be V2 by 2R minus V out by R, and I can cancel out R throughout, and I'm going to get V1 is equal to V2 by 2 plus V2 by 2 minus V out. This will be equal to V1 minus V2 is equal to minus V out. Therefore, V out will be equal to V2 minus V1. What is V2? V2 is the voltage applied at non-inverting terminal, and V1 is the voltage applied at inverting terminal. Look at this particular circuit. V1 is the voltage applied at inverting, V2 is non-inverting. So basically, we have obtained our subtractor circuit. So in order to have a subtractor circuit, voltage that we want to subtract applied through a resistance R1 to inverting terminal, and the voltage from which this voltage needs to be subtracted is fed to a voltage divider arrangement, and from this voltage divider arrangement to non-inverting terminal, and there is a feedback resistance which has the same value as the resistances used. And if I have something like this, that then V out will be equal to V2 minus V1. This is our simple subtractor circuit. I hope you understand this adder and subtractor circuit. Thank you for your time.